Man, Wendell, just when you think you have it all figured out, just when you think you know the end of the story, how this story ends, our future, where we're going when it comes to the toy industry, all of a sudden,
A bleak and dark future.
all of a sudden we feel it's over. And then out of nowhere, when the villain is about to punch out the hero and end it right there, and all of a sudden it's like the Jotomata, kind of moment. And then all of a sudden you look to the horizon, and there the Goku, if you will, the whoever got summoned back by the Dragon Balls.
Or arise from your grave.
Seriously, like out of nowhere, something happens that made my jaw drop, and I actually yelled out loud. I was like, oh my God, when I read the news. Anyone who listened to our KB Toys episode that we did during one of our it was one of our This Day in History segments, so if you check the playlists on our YouTube channel, you'll be able to find it easier that way. But anyone who listened to our KB Toys thing, we were big fans of that branch. Well, here's some crazy news. It seems that in light of the recent news of Toys R Us folding in the United States, a company called Strategic Marks LLC has decided that, due to the fact that Toys R Us will be absent in this market now, they feel that perhaps the IP and the concept of a KB Toys could thrive and survive again in that kind of market, in a post Toys R Us world. And it's funny that they even consider that, because I remember, and mind you, this is my own personal opinion, but I remember in Plattsburgh per se, and I don't know if any of the listeners live in Plattsburgh or the surrounding North New York area, North New York State area,
Vermont, et cetera, et cetera.
Vermont and Burlington and stuff like that. But I remember in Plattsburgh, the KB Toys there was a staple forever, and then a Toys R Us literally moved across from it in the mall. Like
Oh.
they built like this huge extension to the mall, and they built. And I remember when hearing about that, and my family and everyone, we drove down and we got to check out that new Toys R Us, because that was the first time I'd experienced an American Toys R Us.
Okay.
And I think my mom was talking to the KB Toys cashier, and they said, "Oh, we're not too worried about it. It's like apples and oranges." And lo and behold, 2 years after that Toys R Us opened, it closed down, and the KB Toys kept on moving forward. And I think it was just attributed to the fact that KB Toys was a very different animal in how pricing was and product, as opposed to a big box Toys R
Right.
Us.
Wow.
But the flip side of it is, I could also understand how KB Toys probably did have a lot of difficulty, maybe in going into the, because this story that I'm relaying comes from like the late 90s, but I mean, maybe in the early 2000s into the mid 2000s before their demise, in, I think it was 2008 or 2009.
2009,
Yeah,
according to our
2009.
source.
It's just, to me, it's like, I think maybe that. That's what, Toys R Us existing and thriving is what kind of hurt KB Toys. But now you don't have this big monster of a toy store anymore. Instead, now you have, because KB Toys always was the more smaller, modest, mall kind of environment, similar to that of pretty much all the other, like, we have a chain here in Quebec, specifically the province of Quebec in Montreal, called Tour de Jeu. And for the life of me, Tour de Jeu pretty much means like, the tour of, a play on toys, or, and for the life of me, I've never understood how that chain always survived. It was always, they'd always buy one case of whatever action figure from whatever line, one Star Wars case, one Transformer case, one this case, and then a whole bunch of board games and everything. But somehow they've.
I think it's the board game side that they tend to lean on a little bit more, I feel. That
But
and maybe sometimes the Legos.
yeah, maybe, yeah, or the
That's what I'm
Lego, that's true.
thinking.
But I think that it's that kind of environment, and these giant super mall kind of environments, that these smaller stores survive because they don't have to worry about big you know, rent locations or land. When you have a smaller store like that, how many employees do you need on the floor? One, yeah, maybe two, you know, at most, you know, per shift, maybe three if it's a busy Saturday. So there's a lot of factors of labor and cost that are a lot less. KB Toys fit right in with all of that. It's just that when Toys R Us existed, you know, it was, and not to mention when KB went under during a time when Toys were doing gangbusters. You know, the Transformer movie was just coming off of Revenge of the Fallen, where it was just, they were printing money when it came to toy sales. Transformers was doing extremely well then. So it's something that now Toys R Us doesn't exist. That whole factor is gone. Mm. Now KB Toys could come in and become the king of toys, unrivaled now, with no one to go up against them. There's no more Toys R Us, and it'll be that if a parent now goes, hey, let's go Christmas shopping or toy shopping, they'll be the name of the game.
Yeah.
You know, they'll be the, if they're not going online. And if KB Toys chooses to really handle this smartly and really build a strong online and all and stuff like that, it could be quite a boon for them. Not to mention KB Toys had a very good relationship in the past with a lot of different toy companies when it came to exclusives. So they could really use that to their advantage too, where if you want to bring collectors into your stores, all you have to do is get an exclusive figure, an exclusive line, something that Walmart constantly takes advantage of. The current Avengers movies that are coming up and stuff like Infinity War, there's going to be a subsect of Marvel Legends figures that are only Thanos figures, exclusive to Walmart. The same way that a lot of the Hot Rod toys from the last night, all the Hot Rod merchandise was exclusive to Walmart. You wanted a poster of Hot Rod? Walmart had it. Exclusively. The deluxe figure? Walmart had it. Although
I didn't catch on to that at all.
Yeah, but it's true. All the Hot Rod stuff, granted later on, all the Hot Rod stuff, I think it ended up getting more generic packaging and started showing up in other locations much later. But initially, all the Hot Rod stuff was Walmart exclusives. So they really could use that to their advantage, because they were, way before Walmart was getting exclusives or even Target, KB Toys was really the first store to get Transformer exclusives, which dates all the way back to when they had Machine Wars as their exclusive line. So it's something that they could use that as an advantage. They could go into this new market, boom, grand opening, open the doors, and hey, we got an exclusive subsec line or an exclusive figure for this next series of Cyberverse, let's say. You know, we're going to get this character exclusively, or a special repaint. There's so many ways they could go about it. And I mean, it's very, like, when this news broke, a lot of people were saying, oh, it's just an April Fool's joke. Not in mid-March, you know? I don't really, you know, like, that's
kind of ahead.
That's really jumping the gun on an April Fool's joke to be dropping it in, like, as of this recording, March 18th, you know? So it's kind of crazy for them to say that. But I could see this working, not to mention, and I mean, there's an article also when this news dropped from LinkedIn talking about all the 33,000 jobs that are being lost from Toys R Us, not to mention, I don't want to say upper management, but mid-management, at least in terms of store managers and stuff like that. All these people that have experience in the toy industry as managers of a toy store or something, you bring in a KB Toys and you don't even have to shop too far when it comes for employment, because then already you're going to have people that have been used to being floor managers of a toy store, dealing with case assortments and stock and everything. There's going to be literally 33,000, which is more than they'll probably need. They won't need that much, because we're talking 700 Toys R Us's that were closed, where I don't think we're going to have 700 KB Toys opening up to...
Yeah, exactly.
You know, that's not going to be happening overnight or something. I don't think it's ever even been that much. I could be wrong, though. But it's just that they'll have a huge wealth of employees that have been doing this and have experience in this and will be able to fill that role very quickly and fill those jobs if needed. Not to mention, I mean, this news only broke in March. If they could somehow get the ball rolling and have this ready by, let's say, October or November in time for the holiday season, they could really start on a
For them, yeah, they would definitely need it to get done by November, like late November, because of Black Friday. That's when everything
Oh yeah, well that's
really,
true too.
really kicks the ball,
That's true
gets the
too.
ball
You're
going.
right. Yeah, I
That's when
didn't
they
even think
need it
about
to
Black
happen.
Friday also. Yeah. Like but it's something to really, you know, they could start on a positive. You know, go and if anything, if they start, the one good thing especially for them is if they start in October, November, clear December and into January, if the sales aren't good, then at least they'll know early that this probably wasn't a good idea. But
I could only see it. The only downfall I could see it being like this a little bit late, I guess, is that if they do get out by Black Friday and they have crazy deals and stuff, the stock, how's the stock gonna be? You know what I mean?
well,
Getting all those stores, depending on how much they are, getting them all of them supplied. You know, like just like how Target in Canada, like the big issue was that they were never stocked. It was never stocked
and
properly.
my concern especially is that just like how I said in the
Because I
pre
mean, like, think well, and also think about it. Like, everyone knows these guys are coming in. You don't think that they'll try to maneuver themselves to be like, oh, well, we got deals too on toys. We got toys
Oh
too.
no, I can't imagine Walmart or Target just sitting on their hands when another competitor comes around. I'm pretty sure they're probably even going to be contacting the big toy companies like toys or like Hasbro and Mattel and going like,
Mattel or
yeah,
whoever else
and
there
probably
is, you
like
know?
having private discussions with them. It's like, hey, I understand that, you know, KB Toys is back in business, but let's not forget the relationship that we've forged moving, you know, since then. I mean, I'm pretty sure some kind of shady practice will probably come up in the boardrooms of that kind of warfare. But the one thing that also, and it was something that I mentioned in the Toys R Us, one of our Toys R Us discussions. I forget which one it was, but the one thing that I said was, in the absence of Toys R Us, that also takes a whole bunch of buyers that used to shop at Toys R Us, collectors and or, you know, family members and stuff like that for children, and puts a heavy load of now the buyers on other locations. Meaning, like, if you had problems finding stuff at Walmart before, it's going to drastically increase now when more people are going to be shopping at Walmart because they can't go to Toys R Us. So if you had problems buying Transformers in your area, it varies from location to location for every individual, but now it'd be even less so because that Transformer section may be a foot, you know, a foot, 2 foot long by 8 feet, you know, high at most, with maybe 12 pegs and then the bottom shelving of, you know, Voyagers and leader classes that are in short supply. And then whatever gets eaten up of that, just, you know, depending on how much stock is in the back to be able to fill it up again. The problem is even if KB Toys comes in to replace Toys R Us, it's not a one-for-one replacement. KB Toys, their Transformer section was never as massive as Toys R Us's Transformer section. KB Toys was always a limited in space kind of thing. And if you take Walmart's toy aisle, it's as a full unit, it's still much larger than that of a KB Toy store. If you look at their Lego section, their what if KB Toys does come back, I think the first thing they're probably going to have to do is recognize that they're going to have to cut short on certain products that, you know, maybe they might, because they'll probably be in malls. They'll probably be in malls that also have Lego stores. So maybe they'll have to decide not to carry Lego and focus more on the likes of Mega Bloks and the off-brand stuff, and
True,
be
true.
more the go-to for that. In the same way that when I go to Toys R Us, I notice they're really pushing the Mega Bloks Pokemon stuff they're doing currently, Mega Constructs in this case, because since they're not really the go-to for Lego, even though they have a great Lego selection, Toys R Us, they might as well play up what they have something that's unique to them. So
Yeah, exactly.
that's something that I could see KB Toys could do. Maybe dial it back on the
And
Lego.
those sets are pretty cool too. I've
Oh yeah,
gotten a
I
few of
have
them.
the Magikarp one. But I have a few of those throughout the years, but they're pretty cool. So the point is though, is just that's one thing that they could do. They could also just focus again on very specific, you know, just focus on big best-selling brands. They could go, okay, Star Wars does well, Marvel does well, DC does well, Transformers does well, wrestling in the States usually does very well in terms of action figures, Ninja Turtles, maybe, you know, a place for World of Nintendo, because World of Nintendo slowly started coming out of Walmart and started to, I don't want to say it's a Toys R Us exclusive, that's incorrect, but it started to kind of become that, where you could only find them in Toys R Us, specifically in the electronics section, and sometimes in the Pokemon section of a store. But in general, it could be a place for World of Nintendo and Jax and all their stuff and their brands, where Walmart, you know, there's huge selections of stuff that are big aisles that KB Toys can't match. They can't have an aisle of dolls like Walmart does. But I think I'm hoping that this company, Strategic Marks Limited and everything, that they're going to do their research. They're going to know, you know, where to start here. You know, where to start, how to go about this. I mean, I think anyone who's ever had a new Toys R Us open up in their area, or a new Walmart open up in their area, you usually go into that store. I know, especially in the case of Toys R Us, I know when we had a new Toys R Us open up in our area, I was there, like, I think the first or second day, and seeing how all this fresh new wave stock was in there, like everything, not just the Transformers, but all kinds of stuff. And so at least starting off on a good note. And again, you know, grand openings, people always show up for grand openings. So this could be a really good move. And it's something that, like I said, if your biggest rival is now dead, it's a lot easier to come back unrivaled. You know, like it's you know, if you come back and Toys R Us just isn't there anymore, I don't see much of a threat for KB Toys outside of just the market itself. Right. The only thing that could hurt KB Toys now, if they returned, would be the changing market, number one, of how people shop, which is online, and number two, just the changing market of what kids want to spend their money on. You know, where I've said this many times in previous podcasts, I feel that the market has been changing a lot, and the age 5 to, let's say, 15 demographic is not interested in toys anymore. It's a lot of a younger demographic. So I think that only the market itself and the shop and the way of shopping market could hurt KB Toys now. Nothing else can. There's no rivals anymore. And like you said before, sure, a Walmart could step it up and maybe do some boardroom shenanigans, maybe the same thing with Target. But overall, I think KB Toys would have a very healthy market to go into now. And I think this is why this is all even being considered, because like we've said in previous podcasts, where do we fill that hole? What do you do in the absence of Toys R Us in the United Kingdom and United States market here? But, I mean, that's all I could really say. Leave your comments below of what you think of this. I mean, I'm hyped. I love KB Toys, and again, their practices, the way that they functioned, was always something that worked for me. Get rid of old stock when it's not necessary. They don't take losses. They still make profit. But you know, lower the stock, lower the costs, flyers, deals, something that we all. I mean, I'm staring at, you know, movie toys at $30. And, you know, just waiting for a sale that is never going to happen. So, you know, now that Toys R Us is kind of gone, but it's just, well, at least from the United States side of things. So we'll see what happens then. We're going to probably talk in the future as it pertains to Toys R Us Canada and stuff, because there's still a lot more to talk about when it comes